nurtured in their love for God. We also remember today that in marriage, husband and wife are called to a new way of life, created, ordered, and blessed by God. And this way of life is entered into joyfully, but seriously, not carelessly, and also prayerfully. We rejoice today that marriage is given by God, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and sustained by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, let marriage be held in honor by all. Let us pray. Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look mercifully upon Nate and Kara, for they have come seeking your blessing. May your Holy Spirit rest upon them, so that with steadfast love they will honor the promises they make this day. It is through Jesus Christ we pray, and together say, Amen. We are going to do something fancy called the Declarations of Intent, and this is a chance for you to breathe and to know that your vocal cords still work. Are you ready? Kara and Nate, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter this covenant? If so, say, I do. You did it. And now, to the families of Kara and of Nate, do you give your blessing to them and promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in their marriage? If so, say, we do.
We do.
And also, to all those gathered here today, will you, who witness these vows, do everything in your power to uphold Nate and Kara in their marriage? If so, say, we will.
We will.
Good job. I tricked you there.
They'll say, no shirt, no shoes, no service. And have you ever wondered about
not insist on its own way, is not irritable or resentful, and we might stand at that glass door of his letter and say, do we really need a sign for that, Paul? And the answer, of course, is yes. Yes, we need a sign for that. It's a problem, right? It's a problem in that church community, it's a problem in our own communities, and it can be a problem in our homes. If it wasn't, Paul wouldn't have needed to write it out for us. But he has, and it's the words you've chosen for your wedding day. And so it is a great gift, not only to each of us gathered here, to hear this reminder again, but a great gift to the two of you, because it sets the standard for your marriage, for what your marriage will, I'm not going to say can be, I'm going to say will be. Your marriage will be a place where love is not just a word, but it's an action you do when you show patience one for the other. And your marriage will be a place of rejoicing when one of you does well. And it will be a place of bearing all things when things are not going well. Your marriage is the place where love never gives up hope and love never ends. It endures no matter what. Because from this day on, no matter what you face it together. I know that is what you wish for your marriage, and I know it is what each of us gathered here wishes for your marriage. And none of those wishes are going to get to come true unless we all remind ourselves of this day, of the promises you made to each other, and of the prayers that surrounded you on this day, and of the words, the sign that Paul's printed for you. When you feel like, maybe not me, so you remember, oh, love is patient. I remember, and it's kind, not irritable, but not rude. That sign outside restaurants reminds us, too, that you know one person can make a mistake and go in shirtless, even, I suppose, but we do all these things together. We know we do this together. We cannot do it alone. So I want you to take just a moment to not look at people. Look at the promise people. Because they make promise way too people. And look at these two. Look at these folks too. We made a promise today too, if you remember. We made a promise to do everything we can to uphold them in their life together. So you don't do this alone. We are assigned for you as well. That love is patient and love is kind and love endures all things that never ends. So, with the sign on the door, they needed it because someone went in shirtless. And Paul gives us the sign because we need it. But we also are reminded of the great promise that faith, hope, and love, these three, and the greatest is love.
Daddy.
You can do flowers to her face.
Daddy.
And will you join hands? Since it is your intention to marry, you now, with your promises, bind yourselves to one another as husband and wife. Nate, you go first. Before God and these witnesses, I, Nate, take you, Kara,
to be my wife.
And I promise to love you.
And I promise to love you.
And to be faithful to you.
And to be faithful to you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
All right, Karen. Before God and these witnesses. It's okay, we can go slow, word by word. By your blessing, O God, may love and faithfulness. May they always remind them of the covenant they've made this day. It is through Jesus Christ our Lord we pray. Amen. Solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the joining of hands.